The foundation for economics is rationality. In order to choose, you must have a set of preferences over the options you are presented with. These preferences must fulfill a set of criteria in order to fulfill the necessary requirements of being classed as rational. The first axiom is completeness. That is, whether one is indifferent to or prefers one set of options over another, they must always be able to make that choice. For all A and B, elements of set X, we have that either A is at least as preferred as B, or B is at least as preferred as A, or both at the same time. Transitivity is the second axiom by which consumers are able to order their preferences in a logical way. For all A, B, and C, elements of set X, we have that if A is at least as preferred as B, while B is at least as preferred as C, consequently A should be at least as preferred as C. The axiom of reflexiveness has a purely formal purpose. This axiom simply implies that A is at least as preferred as itself. Continuity simply means that there are no jumps in people's preferences. In mathematical terms, if we prefer point A along a preference curve to point B, points very close to A will also be preferred to B. This allows indifference curves to be differentiated. This axiom provides to the utility function its continuous condition. These four axioms are the basic set of premises that economics requires of individuals in order to be rational economic agents. It also enables us to represent preferences graphically. However, a later set of axioms were studied and added by Samuelson as preferable. Because people are inherently insatiable, and we always want more of what we like, we derive the premise of monotonicity. Weak monotonicity implies that if A contains more than B, or at least the same quantity of goods, A is at least as preferred as B. On the other hand, strong monotonicity implies that if A and B contain the same amount, but A contains more of at least one good, then A is strictly preferred to B. This axiom is responsible for the increasing function characteristic of the utility function. Further developing our taste for variety, we inherently prefer baskets of goods or choices which contain a wider range. Utility is the satisfaction we get from using, owning, or doing something. It is what allows us to choose between options. This can be plotted on a chart. The x-axis or horizontal axis shows the amount of income M available to the consumer, while the y-axis or vertical axis shows the amount of utility U derived from consuming goods. Utility functions follow the same code of product, the same axioms, as preferences, because they are simply numerical representations of them. As a result of the monotonicity axiom, the utility function is increasing. The more that we have of a good, the higher our utility will be. Between the different points, we have a continuous function, showing that there are no jumps between preferences, fulfilling the continuity axiom. As a result of diminishing returns, the utility function has a quasi-concave shape, representing that marginal utility decreases as the number of goods consumed, in terms of income spent, increases. This is explained as an extra unit of a good has a greater value when the individual has a low amount of that good than when they have many of it. Indifference curves are lines in a coordinate system for which each of its points express a particular combination of a number of goods or bundles of goods that the consumer is indifferent to consume. The consumer will therefore have no preference between two bundles located in the same indifference curve, since they all provide the same degree of utility. In this graph, the x-axis or horizontal axis represents the amount of good x1, which corresponds to apples, and on the y-axis or vertical axis, the amount of good x2, which corresponds to bananas. Let's see again all of the axioms we've just studied using the chart. Reflexiveness, completeness, continuity, transitivity, convexity, and monotonicity. When we draw indifference curves showing different degrees of utility, we call it an indifference map, which is helpful to determine how utility increases when consumption increases. Utility functions may be represented with indifference curves of various shapes, depending on each function.